Alright guys, welcome to another edition of Breaking Down the News. And there's something that has been happening. If you're watching the news or if you know what's happening in the world right now, you don't even have to know because it's so everywhere. It's really ubiquitous. The floods. Floods, floods, floods everywhere. What does it mean? What is God trying to tell us through these things? Because God speaks not only through His word, but also through the things happening. But obviously we know, because the word of God tells us, that in the last days there will be troublous times, there will be crazy times happening in our world. And today we'll be looking at the floods, and it's really tough what's happening in the world, and we will see what God is trying to tell us. And I'll share my screen here as we begin our topic. When the enemy comes in like a flood is what we're talking about today. Who is the enemy, and what does it mean for the enemy to come in as a flood? And so let's start off with what's happening. So just this month, July, you can see on the screen that we've had floods all over the world, almost simultaneously on every single continent. You have Asia, Europe, North America, Africa, South America, Australia. Now, in case you don't believe me, I'll show you here. Moving on to the next slide. And this was today. This was 25th July, London flooding. See what's going on here. Isn't that crazy? Can you believe it? This is just London, right? But wait, there's more. Oh, actually, I need to pause this. There's more. Moving on here. This is India.
Calm after the chaos. But an all too familiar scene across India. It's hard for many to take in. Homes and lives destroyed. Household items are all that's left. A reminder of how relentless the annual monsoon rains have been this year. For Ankita, the pain of loss is just too much to bear.
I can't see anything here. My house, my people, my neighbors. I cannot find anyone.
Flooding and landslide in this village in the state of Maharashtra have left people with nothing.
Yesterday, we didn't have the material for cremation. It was raining heavily. We had nothing, so that's why we dug a pit and buried everyone together.
Now, this is not an isolated case. I'll just pause here. Moving on. This is Belgium. So this is Europe, right? I believe. Now watch. Can you believe this? This is the sights we are seeing. What does this all mean? And to even think of the damage involved here, it's crazy, right? Well, because of time, we won't have to watch all the devastation, but this is just a highlight of what's happening just this month. This
cities in China's Henan province are underwater after China. They saw what weather officials are calling the heaviest rains for 1,000 years. At least 25 people have died during the flooding, including a dozen in a subway line in the capital of Zhengzhou. Rail and road transport have been disrupted, while dams and reservoirs have swollen to warning levels. Thousands of troops, firefighters, and other emergency responders are in the midst of rescue efforts across the region, including pulling more than 500 people from the flooded subway, according to officials.
The
Again, because of time, we don't have to go through all of this, but these are just highlights. And the same thing happened in Belgium again here, and you have some sites in Arizona, and I found this very interesting and very really touching moment. See what happens. For me, this is the touching moment to see that even through the disasters, you have people who are willing, I mean, to just help. And when you see that God is working also, even though there's destruction all over, that there's still the grace of God. And yeah, that's really a moving moment for me. And I can't imagine for them. Anyways, these are just instances. We can't go through everything, but yeah, it's been tough this month, and even in Africa. This is Nigeria, I believe, the Lagos.
Particularly affected was many people reached their destination on foot on the water.
All right. Because of time again, we won't go through all of this, but there's even Australia
tonight,
here.
What a mess. Streets and homes flooded as rows of storms sweep across Perth. Live reports on the damage, the cleanup, the forecast of worse to come.
Short, sharp, but dangerous.
All this is this month. This is officially the month of floods. Officially, I would say this is the month of floods, where there's destruction all over. But you know, I think we should just take a moment here and just pray for all these things before we delve into what they mean. We want to make sure we actually process what's going on and present everything to God. And I know I've prayed for people in private, but I also feel like it's not enough to just be the preaching poet or the singing poet, but we must become the praying poets as well. So the praying poet is the new thing here. But yeah, prayer is really powerful. It unlocks the storehouses of heaven. And not only that, it actually moves the hand of God, but it also shows where our heart is truly. And so that much further delays, I think we should just take a moment to pray for people who are suffering and those who are victims of these disasters. And so let's do that. Heavenly Father, thank you for your grace and love. And we know it's hard to say those words to those who are suffering. And it's really hard for them, those who are suffering, to actually say these words that you are loving and caring. But Lord, we know you are, because above all evil, you still reign and you're still loving. And you showed us that you loved us when you gave your only begotten Son. Lord, we know there's so much evil in this world. Lord, I pray that you give us to truly understand what is happening here. What is at stake, and what do these things mean? Why is the world in the state that it is in? And so Lord, as we study your word, I pray that you open our eyes, that we may behold your true character, not the fake and scandalous character that the devil tries to paint, and the accusations he tries to make, painting a God that is not loving. But let us see you today for who you truly are. And also let us see in these signs what they mean, because you told us that there will be disasters and that these disasters will show that the end is near and that we are living in the last days. And so, Lord, open our eyes, forgive us our sins, comfort those who are suffering, the families that have lost their loved ones, Lord. Heal, build and mend them, but above all, Lord, I pray that you would bring them and give them eternal life, that they, even though we die in this world, that on the resurrection morning, that they will rise in Christ first and be received up into glory. This is my prayer, in Jesus' name, amen. Right, so we don't have much time, but there's a few things to cover here. So, first of all these floods, all these evil things prove and show that everything in the world is crying in pain. Like Romans 8:22 says, "For we know that the whole creation groans and travails in pain together until now." I showed you every continent, and the floods are just one aspect, but you have other crazy disasters that are happening. And all this shows that the world is in a state of perplexity. The world right now is in a state of chaos and disorder, pain, groaning, crying. Everyone is affected. That is the state of our world. But the good news is, how does God fit into this picture? Well, God is also grieving with us. Here are some verses that shows that. Judges 10:16, Isaiah 63:9, it says, "His soul was grieved for the misery of Israel." And if God can be grieved for Israel, we know he's also grieved for us, because God loves all people. And Israel were God's people, just like we have people today who are God's Israel as well, as long as they do his will and they do his commandments, right? And also, in all their affliction, he was afflicted, and he bare them and carried them all the days of old. So, in fact, the character of God, if you read Exodus 34, it says that he's merciful and gracious, long-suffering. All right? So that's a character of God. But not only is he that, he is also just. And the Word of God says of God's character that God is just as well. So in the events that are happening, we may discern a few things that are interesting, but I want to point out what Jesus Christ does for us and what the Spirit of God does, that His Spirit, when we pray, makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. So how does God deal with the groaning of human creation? The Spirit of God also makes intercession for us with the equivalence of our groanings, so that God hears our prayers, because sometimes we don't even know how to pray. We don't even know what to say. So that's the good news there, that, you know, as we are suffering down here, the Spirit of God is suffering with us, that God is grieving with us. So what do we do? Well, of course, we need to help people where we can, and, you know, share the resources that we have and do all amazing things. Pray, of course, like we've just done. But if there's something practical you can do to your community, if you're a part of the community that is suffering, then use God-given resources to help the people, because that's why God put you there. But what can we do now, spiritually? Well, look at this verse and tell me what you think. Let me know your thoughts in the comment. Matthew 24:14 says, "This gospel of the kingdom shall be preached unto all nations," for a witness, of course, "and then the end will come." So that means if we truly present the gospel, then we can bring all this misery to an end. So there's a key in here, that if we share the gospel faithfully, the end of the world will come sooner than delayed, right? And so we can speed up the process by sharing the gospel, because that's what God wants everybody to hear. God wants everyone to have an opportunity before some events unfold on this world. So why floods? Well, there is different applications or different, you know, explanations why floods happen. Scientifically, well, there's moisture in the atmosphere, too much moisture that the atmosphere can't hold, and there's too much rains, and it's really a complicated array of reasons if you think about it. In fact, even these recent floods, there's many reasons why they happened. One could say, obviously, it's the global warming, for example, was there's too much heat in the atmosphere, and when there is too much heat, and the precipitation happens often and more rapidly. Another would say it's maybe the infrastructure of our cities, maybe, because you know, we find that there's so much surface ceiling that there's no place for water to be absorbed into the ground, so it just spreads all over, right? Because it doesn't have where to go. There's many applications to that. And so that's why I believe there's another reason behind all these things, because like we see, it's not just one reason why these things are happening. So you can say climate change, but it cannot just be climate change. There has to be another reason that explains what is happening in our world. And that reason, before we go into that reason, let's read this verse where our presentation is based as a flood. Isaiah 59:19. The word of God says, "When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him." The enemy obviously is the devil. And God is saying when the devil comes in like a flood, there's something God does to that, to stay that or to counteract that. And he lifts his standard. What is this standard and what is this flood? Well, spiritually speaking, a flood is whatever evil that overwhelms God's people, whatever temptation that the devil brings on them, whatever trials and tribulation of all kinds that he brings, when these things happen, God raises up his standard. But what is this standard of God? Obviously, this standard is Jesus Christ himself. But then we just read that it's actually the truth. The truth is God's standard. The truth, the gospel, is the standard of God. And when we are faced with trial and tribulation all around, when we are faced with things we can't explain, God's standard helps us understand. The gospel, the word of God, is the simplifier of life. And it actually explains away life's perplexities. And primarily that speaks to who's responsible for the floods. Now we're speaking literally. The floods, the evil in this world, who's responsible? Well, Matthew 13:28, Jesus says the enemy has done this. God created everything beautiful, but the enemy destroyed it. And he perverted everything, and he brought suffering into this world. So the devil is responsible. But on the other hand, God also uses floods, and he uses the elements of the world for his purposes as well. And if you want to think of this, think of the story of Job. And I did a video on this. You can watch the video somewhere here. It's really important because it outlines that, you know, what's happening in our world. Yes, the devil is doing some of these things, but God allows him to. And God has a purpose for everything. There's a verse in Proverbs, it says, "Everything is for the Lord, even the wicked for the day of judgment." That's an interesting verse. But yeah, God uses floods as well. And there's an interesting quote as we close. It's found from the book Prophets and Kings, page 277. This was written many years ago, but these things are happening right now. Listen, it says, "The time is at hand when there will be sorrow in the world that no human balm can heal, no human remedy, no human, you know, soothing can heal. The Spirit of God is being withdrawn. Disasters by sea and by land follow one another in quick succession." Haven't we seen that in the recent days, right? Even this month, how frequently we hear of earthquakes and tornadoes, of destruction by fire and flood, with great loss of life and property. How many people have died due to these floods? It's incomprehensible, right? Apparently, these calamities are capricious outbreaks of disorganized, unregulated forces of nature wholly beyond the control of man. But in the more, God's purposes may be read. They are among the agencies by which he seeks to arouse men and women to the sense of their danger. Now, you may be saying, that doesn't make sense. How does, you know, flooding places arouse people to their danger? Well, the real danger is what's coming ahead. There will be seven last plagues, as foretold in the book of Revelation chapter 16. And everyone who does not have the seal of God will receive these last plagues, will be a victim of these plagues, because they will have decided to be with the world and to be with the devil, and they have nothing to do with God. And so God judges people because of their deeds, because they've trampled upon the law of God, and because they have rejected the mercy of God. And so really, it's like, what else is God gonna do? He's tried his best, right? And so when we take ourselves away from God, we are placing ourselves in greater danger. The story of Job again. God protects Job because Job hates evil. Do you hate evil? Because if you don't hate evil, chances are God is not really protecting you, because you're not inviting his protection. So the devil goes to God and says, Job, you're protecting Job. And that's true, because God protects his people. And when we take ourselves from his protection, we are going to face all these dangers, because the devil is prepared to cause as many natural disasters as he can, as many floods as he can. He's the prince of the air. He can cause disasters. We read that in the book of Job. But our question we have to ask to ourselves is, are we ready? Are we ready to die anytime? Because if we are not ready, it means we are not truly in God, and perhaps maybe God is not truly protecting us. So yeah, God protects people, but not all people. God protects those who allow him to legally protect them. Because if you are legally on the devil's side, then, you know, God is a God of justice, and he cannot force things. So this is a great controversy that's happening, friends. It's really not just floods moving. It's in these floods alone and natural disasters, we can see a great controversy between good and evil that's happening. And this controversy is really about the law of God, the fairness of God, the justice of God. The devil is saying, you don't have to keep the law of God. The devil is saying God does not exist. And then he causes all these floods and all these evil calamities to just kill as many people as he can before they accept Jesus Christ. But you know, this is your chance today to accept Christ while he's sitting on the chair of mercy, while he's still interceding for us in the sanctuary. You know, Jesus predicted there will be all these things, and we see these things happening. So really, we are living in the last days, and this is a moment of reflection. As we look on these floods and really think on these things, let us really transition in our minds and think of the real flood. Now, I'm not saying the floods we're seeing are not floods, but there's truly a real flood coming. There's a time of trouble ahead of us. The last plagues, the seven last plagues that are terrific, more than any flood we've ever seen. If we don't receive God now, if our hearts are not truly converted, we are going to suffer these things. But as we close, just, you know, a spiritual application of this verse. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. You know, the devil is trying everything he can to win your heart away. The devil is trying everything he can do to destroy you, to make sure you do not receive God. You know, the purpose of the devil is to hold people in impenitence or in rebellion or in rejecting God until probation is closed. You know, God's mercy is not forever, right? Because God is merciful and just, yes. God's grace is there, yes. But one day, like in the days of Noah, the door is going to close. Then that means we must be careful to use our God-given time and talents for his glory, and to repent of our sins, not tomorrow, but today, to always be ready. When the enemy comes in like a flood, temptations, floods, lift the standard of truth, the word of God, the gospel. Let it be your guide. Preach the gospel, because that's what people need. Even those who are suffering, they truly need to hear what is going on. Why are these floods happening? Well, an enemy has done this. The devil is causing these things. But also God uses these elements to awake us to a sense of our responsibility. God has called us to share the gospel, and he's waiting for us to do just that. The sooner we do that, the sooner the world ends, and the sooner we are relieved of these breaking heart news, if you will. So thank you guys for joining me today. I hope you have a good day, and I hope that you are enshrouded in God's protection. And just a final thought, it does not mean that those who die in these floods or earthquakes and all that are not guided by God, or they're not protected by God in that sense. Because look at Job. God can't permit the devil to do things. And sometimes we can't understand everything, but we have to trust him. Because like in the story of Job didn't understand everything. There was a sense of some ignorance that was going on. But later he truly understood that God is just and fair, and that the devil is the cause of all these problems. So thank you so much, guys. If you like this video, please share with your friends and keep praying that God would, you know, the book of Revelation speaks of angels holding the winds of the four winds, you know, of heaven, so that the plagues should not fall on this world yet until God's people are sealed. So are you being sealed by God? Do you have the seal of God in your heart? Are you truly on God's side? Because if you are not, my friend, worse than these things is coming ahead. So as we close, in fact, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thanks for your word. Thanks for your comforting words that you protect your children. Truly, we cannot know how much we owe to you for the peace and security we enjoy. So thank you for this moment of peace that we have, and for those who are passing through disasters and calamities, someone who may be watching this, Lord, I pray that you would be with them. And the fact that they're watching this means you have sustained them. So Lord, teach us to trust you more. It is not because of their sins that they have died, but unless we repent, you told us clearly that we will likewise perish. So teach us your wisdom, teach us to understand your word. In Jesus' name I ask and pray.